And welcome back to CTV News. At noon, we have got some animals looking for new homes. Humane Society Officer Nicole from the Edmonton Humane Society is joining us with a couple cute little guys here, or girls.
Guys, both of them are guys.
Okay, before we get to these ones, let's take a look at the animals from last week. I believe we had Shirley, a cat. Tell us what happened there.
Shirley is still at the shelter waiting for her home, but Cartman has been adopted, our dog.
Yes. And tell us a little bit again about Cartman.
Cartman was the lab and Great Dane cross, and he was approximately 3 years old, and he came in as a stray, I believe.
And adopted really quickly?
Yes, very quickly, the day of the show.
And what about Shirley?
Shirley's still at the shelter. She was our pet of the week last week, but she hasn't found a home yet.
Okay, what kind of family would she be good for?
Any family, really. She's great with other cats, and she's good with other kids and people, so.
Okay, let's talk about the cat that you've got. Tell us a little bit about this one.
This is Neighborino, and he is 4 years old. He as well is really good with other animals. He just doesn't like being shoved in his kennel. But he came in as a stray from Animal Care and Control, and he has had a little haircut, so that's why he looks the way he does right now. But he's a really good guy, and he loves love, and he loves being around people.
And does he shed a lot? He's not a hairless. He was just kind of
trimmed
up.
He's not a hairless. He's a medium hair, so his hair is approximately like that normally. So he does need to be groomed and brushed.
Yeah. And who am I holding here?
That is Stedman.
This is Stedman. Come on, how cute is that?
He's a one-year-old terrier cross, and he was also a stray that came in from Animal Care and Control. He's very loving. He would do best in a home with older children, though.
And why is that?
Just because they're a little overwhelming, the younger ones for him. He's a little shy at first, so he needs some time to warm up to people. But once he does, he's actually very loving.
Tell us about the number of strays you guys get. A lot of these animals are strays brought in by members of the public. What are the numbers looking like right now?
The numbers in general, I'm not sure, but sometimes we can get up to like 40 admissions a day. So,
how has the new building, the new home for you guys, made a difference? And caring for these animals and getting a lot of them adopted.
It's very nice for them because they're not shoved in cages anymore. So they have a lot of space. They can interact with each other. The cats are kept in rooms together. And the dogs get a lot of attention as well because people can go into their rooms and play with them and they're not stuck in there anymore. So they get a lot of attention and people get to see them directly and see how they interact with the family when they come in, so it's really good for them.
Are these rare breeds? Am I holding a rare breed or is this one of the more common breeds that you guys get in?
Yeah, it's a common breed. We get a lot of terriers into the shelter, a lot of Rottweilers.
And what about the cat that you're holding?
The cat is common as well. We get a lot of these in, but yeah.
So when a family comes in looking for a new animal, do they usually come with, is it a child making the decision a lot of the time? Do they have a lot of influence when these guys are being picked up?
I would say they do, which is probably why we like to let them know whether or not they're good with younger or older children, because a lot of the kids want to pick the pets, but it differs with every family.
And again, this would be better with an older child.
Yes.
An older, what age group were we looking at?
Oh, probably over 10 would be best, just because he's so shy and he needs a lot of patience and you need to be very careful. Not careful, but just be calm around him.
He's wincing a little bit, the cute little guy.
Oh, wow.
He's a little nervous maybe.
He is nervous, yes.
Yeah. Well, thanks for coming in. We really do appreciate it. And hopefully we can find these animals a new home. If you'd like to take any of the pets we introduced to you today, you can contact the Humane Society, 471-1774, website edmontonhumanesociety.com. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.